I will be speaking to you today on, to some people, quite sensitive subject. But I don't think I've ever talked about money on tribal trails.
He chose to walk with us.
We're talking to Christians, of course. You're a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ. I think it's right that we teach on everything that is relating to the Christian's relationship with God and that which has to do with his walk with the Lord here on earth. I am not asking for money. Could I make that quite clear now, okay? I'm going to read one verse here, and there are other verses relating to the Christian's support of their church, their missions, etc. Chapter 16 of 1 Corinthians says, "Now concerning the collection for the saints, as I have given order to the churches of Galatia, even so you do. Upon the first day of the week, let every one of you lay by him in store as God has prospered him, that there be no gatherings when I come." Okay, when we become Christians, we have a new sense of how we view things, especially in relation to the work of God. When I became a Christian, I sensed anew, not like before, as long as, gone to church, not very much, but gone to church, as long as some noise was made on the offering plate, that's giving. However, after I became a Christian, I learned some things about our relationship with God, what he gives us, and what we do with it. We're responsible to God. When the Lord saves us, he gives us a sense of belonging in the group, in the church. The church this time is not the building, but the group of people that we worship with. The word church is the ones that have been called out by God. And so when we've been born again, been brought to salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, then our responsibilities lie in different parts. One, we can actually do things for people, helping people. Second, we can also help people in the area of finances. We can also support missionaries. I refer to a verse here in Matthew that says, "Where your treasure is, there will your heart be also." It is referring to people who were thinking of this life more than the next one. That they should be careful that our longing, desire is based on God's word, and that we grow to this place where, as Christians, we want to do what we can while we're here. But our heart is in God's direction as to what his plan and will is here on earth. Now, we talk about tithing. It is an Old Testament teaching. Not only was money to be a tenth given, but even the produce, what they grew, they gave one tenth. And God spoke to them in Malachi 3, I believe it is, that God had told them to tithe. That is one-tenth. That's a whole lot, isn't it? God said to them, "Prove me. This is mine, what I gave you. What I gave you, you give back one-tenth." In the New Testament, much the same. But it works this way. It's not like legal, like in the Old Testament, it was the law to do so. That if you're an Israelite, this applied to you. And However, here in this verse that I read, Paul had been teaching the people in Corinth. He says, just like I taught them at Galatia, I'll teach you the same thing. He said to them, as God has prospered you. Now, I know there's different interpretations on this, and I won't go to any great length in arguing about it as to what it means, but you can read it yourself. I'm convinced this way. And when he says, lay by him as God had prospered him, I don't think there's any hard and fast rule to that, that you could be praying to God for his blessing on your gifts, that you will come to the place where you'll find that it's more blessed to give than to receive. I've been in the ministry for maybe a little past 60 years, and I know many missionaries in the northern part of Canada. There's a standard by which they must raise so much to go to, well, anywhere. I believe this needs to be taught more. I know there's reluctance on the part to even mention it, because when you mention finances or money, you're after it, they say. I don't think that's the case. I believe we need to be taught in Scripture on different areas of life that has to do with our responsibility to the Lord. Romans 10, it says, how can they preach except they be sent? That word sent there is not just telling a person, you go and serve over there. Within that sent is the financial aspect of our supporting of missionaries. The person that is sent by people who are supporting him in the ministry. I want to say something there. It's been proven beyond a shadow of a doubt that if you honor the Lord in giving, he will honor you. Why is it done this way? There's one verse that is not a troubling verse, that God has ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. That's interesting, because when your whole time is given to service, you can't do it alone. Now you say you have God. Yes, God has people too, to stand behind others, and they must be faithful in it. I believe God opens our eyes to it, and God blesses people who trust in God of their support of others. Now, while I'm saying this, when we hear of others abusing the system, it's harder for us to get the message across that's in the Word of God. For instance, I know of TV preachers who ask for money even though they do have millions. But we're talking about average people, a Christian who wants to do right. Do what you can in the area of tithing, and God will bless you for it. Since I understood it, I started tithing, and I proved God to be faithful in what he says. God give you guidance and direction. God bless you.